हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द पोएम डैफोडिल्स, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पोएम्स ऑफ विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ. विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ इज़ नोन एज नेचर पोएट एंड यू विल सी द लव ऑफ वर्ड्सवर्थ फॉर नेचर थ्रू दिस पोएम. व्हेन एंड हाउ दिस पोएम वॉज कंपोज्ड. वंस व्हेन वर्ड्सवर्थ केम अक्रॉस अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ डैफोडिल्स व्हाइल वांडरिंग इन द वुड्स अलॉन्ग विथ हिज सिस्टर डोरोथी, वर्ड्सवर्थ गेव poetic expression to his experience in form of the poem Daffodils. It is the outcome of actual visualization rather than imagery. Daffodil is Wordsworth's most famous work and shows vividly his love of nature. It underlines the idea that beautiful objects of nature like daffodils, flowers that bloom earliest in the spring in England, fill our minds with pleasure. Look at the first stanza. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high over valleys and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd. The poet was wandering like a cloud. Here, like a cloud is a figure of speech, simile. It refers to some similarities between two persons or things. The poet compares himself with a cloud that freely floating over hills and valleys. He too was wandering freely in the woods, and suddenly his eyes fell upon a large belt of golden daffodils blooming along the bank of a lake. This beautiful sight attracted his attention. You see, when all at once I saw a crowd, he addressed them a host, as if they were welcoming the poet being their guest. A crowd is, again, the word is used for, it is a collective noun used to denote a number of people. So here, the poet personified daffodils. What is personification? It means attributing human qualities to a non-living thing. The poet personified daffodils and addressing, saying them as a crowd, a host. So here both, both the words, a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, refers to personification. A host of golden daffodils. Host means here personification. A host, as if the host is welcoming. The poet himself thinks as he is a guest, and the flowers are host of golden daffodil. The adjective golden is used here. The two reason the golden is, one is the color, yellow color of the flowers, and second is these are very precious, like the metal gold. So the poet has used here golden daffodils. Beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze, a gentle breeze made these flowers wave and tossing their heads in the cool air as if in a dance. This scenic beauty captivated the poet. He tried to convey the idea that there is an inherent unity between man and nature. Now come to the second stanza. Continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way. Here, again the figure of speech simile, the poet compares the beautiful flowers with the shining stars in the Milky Way. They are also as numerous as the stars. They stretched in never-ending line along the margin of a bay. The flowers spread in a long line on the bank of the lake. They stretched in never-ending line. It highlights a large number of flowers and their beauty that seemed to form an endless line beside the lake. 10,000 I saw at a glance, tossing their heads in sprightly dance. He saw a large number of them moving their heads as if they were dancing and enjoying. The daffodils are again personified as human beings dancing. 10,000 saw I at a glance means the poet wants to highlight the abundance of flowers. We can also say that it is an exaggeration. And another figure of speech, hyperbole. tossing their heads in sprightly dance. The flowers are, when the wave is blowing, the cool breeze is blowing, the flowers are moving, so it's looking as if they are dancing, they are tossing their heads and dancing, enjoying. It is the beautiful scene of the golden daffodils that mesmerized the poet. Now the remaining two stanzas will be in the second video.